थैंक यू मैम, थैंक यू सो मच. एंड द बेसिक इंस्पिरेशन ऑफ मी गेटिंग इन टू फ्रॉम आउट ऑफ ऑप्स एंड गायनी टू एमरजेंसी मेडिसिन वॉज एग्जैक्टली माई मदर, हु आई हैव लॉस्ट ड्यूरिंग एन RTA इन बिटवीन द जोन वैन आई वॉज ट्राइंग फॉर DNB कोर्सेज. एंड दैट इज़ हाउ आई थिंक दैट गायनी तो बहुत कर लिया बिकॉज आई लॉस्ट माई मदर इन एन RTA विद on inotropes and I don't know, being a gynecologist in 2016, I have just no idea what is that NORAD is going on and everything, and I just got an opportunity and I thought it, why not to avail, it is really going to helpful in a long run. So ma'am, to start with, our main concern is maternal mortality, and we are having lot of patients who are walking normal, everything is normal, they are at low risk. And they are low risk patients and they can become high risk at any point of time. It is not like tertiary hospital, we have to be well aware of the resuscitation. It has to be everywhere. At least we take out their golden period. We should not let them die in front of us. That is the whole aim, that you resuscitate during that golden period and transfer them appropriately to the centers. Even in my labor room, if a patient collapses, I need to resuscitate and shift to ICU 4, which I have to do it in that golden period. Otherwise, it is go in an irreversible phase. Baad mein help karne ka koi fayda nahi hai. That is how your skills has to be. You have to be always toes, always anticipated what could be the problem and how you have to solve it. So literally, whenever a patient comes, like this is a lady, when comes and she is collapsing in the labor room, what is the first reaction? Everybody got panic and they thought, what exactly have to do? Nobody shout, asking for a help is sign. Sister ji, monitor do, oxygen do, cannula do, fluid do, examine karo, aray anesthesia wale ko bulao, everything, ek koi ABG ka sample lo. So what is actually emergency medicine is a protocolized manner of exactly how you have to approach. If a person of emergency medicine is resuscitating that patient and reaches to the point C, that if the another one comes, he knows exactly what has been done and now what has to be done. So that means it is completely protocolized, nothing cures. Very much significant, bus, yes, it has a protocol, it has an approach of exactly how we have to resuscitate them. So to start with, my first question is, we are talking about maternal collapse, maternal arrest, what is the difference between the two? Anyone? Anita ma'am, you can tell? After 2 hours, please forget this term of pulseless BPless. That's for sure, I really want you to escape out this term. So ma'am, is a maternal pulseless BP-less is a cardiac arrest?
No.
So pulseless BP-less is a live patient?
Yes.
And that could be a collapse?
Yes.
Yeah. So pulseless BP-less, whatever we write, is actually a
wrong.
Which pulse? Wrong term. It's actually a wrong term because nothing is, if patient is not having a pulse, cannot have a BP and cannot be live, ideally. So we are very specific to call a cardiac arrest when it is carotid-less. Rather than pulse, it is a carotid, which is the least blood pressure of 60. If carotid is present, your blood pressure is 60.
Okay.
Pulse-less, BP-less is no term. But if your carotid is present, it means you have at least 60 ka blood pressure.
So that
could not be appear on the monitor. Monitor pe aapko BP-less milega. Carotid hai to BP hai. Carotid नहीं है तो BP नहीं है, तो that is carotid absent, no breathing, that is a cardiac arrest. So that is the two different things. तो pulseless, BP-less तो कभी files में डालना ही नहीं है. You feel whether carotid is present or not. Carotid present means it's already having a BP and that is not a cardiac arrest. So what is maternal collapse is? It could be transient syncopal attack or unconscious or becoming hypotensive so that the other pulses have gone. Patient become very cold, clammy extremities, or the patient may shows a seizure, which is the most common cause of maternal cardiac collapse, which we are encountering, that is a seizure. It could be a normal, it could be eclampsia one, but ideally a transient syncopal episode, which is because of the postpartum state or the antenatal phase, is a maternal collapse. So it is an acute event involving a cardiorespiratory system or CNS, resulting in a reduced or an absent conscious level at any stage in the pregnancy up to 6 weeks after delivery, and it can be potentially lead to cardiac arrest. That is why we have to act upon a maternal collapse to prevent that patient going in a cardiac arrest and death. The collapsed patient can be collapsed but responsive, or it could be collapsed with unresponsive. Both can be there. And this is a very small subset of a woman who is affected by maternal collapse. तो कार्डियक अरेस्ट इज अ वेरी स्मॉल सबसेट ऑफ दोज पेशेंट्स. तो वॉट इज एग्जैक्टली एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन, दैट मीन्स हार्ट स्टॉप्स एक्टिविटी. इफ देर इज नो एक्टिविटी ऑफ द हार्ट, नो ऑर्गेनाइज कार्डिक एक्टिविटी विद अ हीमोडायनेमिक कोलैप्स, देर इज नो कैरोटिड आर्टरी, नो ब्रीदिंग. द पेशेंट मे बी गैस्पिंग, बट इफ द कैरोटिड्स आर एब्सेंट, इट इज मैटरनल कार्डिक अरेस्ट. एंड इफ करेक्टिव मेजर्स आर, इट इज स्टिल रिवाइवेबल, इट इज स्टिल रिवर्सिबल. बट इफ करेक्टिव मेजर्स आर नॉट टेकन, इट प्रोग्रेसेस टू सडन कार्डिक डेथ एंड इट मे गेट रिवर्स बाय इफेक्टिव CPR और डिफिब्रिलेशन. दैट इज वाई इन आर रीसेसिटेशन वी आर आस्किंग, whenever we are asking to start a resuscitation of any patient, we are asking, yeah, we want to activate an emergency response team, get an AED or a defibrillator if we are in the hospital and the crash cart, and then we approach the patient. Because this cardiac arrest, if the cardiac arrest is there, you have to promptly start a compression along with a defibrillator has to be the part of your resuscitative team. If you are outside the hospital, we have AED, which is automated external defibrillators. And the most common cause of cardiac arrest is cardiac origin only, especially in non-pregnant. If you are talking about in general in outside the hospital or at home, it is because of the ventricular fibrillations due to myocardial infarction, and which are actually reversible. Any layman person, in fact, outside, though it is very much mandatory for 10th examination also that they should have a BLS certificate, then they'll give them 10th and 12th. So even in the schools it is mandatory, but hamare yahan par to being a doctors also many of us are actually not trained with the BLS, how exactly we have to go about. So how do we identify a pregnant or a postnatal? Yes ma'am, I'm truly speaking, none of them are trained. Being sitting in a casualty of LNJP, which I'm going to turn to the emergency physician, I'll tell you, our CMOs, our JRs who are resuscitating those patients, they are not trained in BLS. And they become so confident, why should we learn? Because we are doing practical experiments for last 20 years. But still they don't know the protocols, they are playing with their lives actually. So how do we identify? Can we identify that this patient is going to go in a cardiac arrest or a collapse? So that we can anticipate and we can reverse the event even before they become collapse.
Patient will become delirious.
Ma'am, before collapse. I'm asking, not even before collapse, can I anticipate, like I have 10 patients in the labor room and these two patients are going to, that are the high risk factors, that we know. But all high risk does not necessarily go in cardiac arrest, and the low risk can also go in a collapse. So can we have something different apart from the risk categorization that we are doing? That is already a collapse. I want at pre that. Tachypnea, like half an hour back it was, I'll be a little more interactive because PPT padh dene ka, I don't think there is a point. But the patient who is actually having a tachypnea of 30 right now, or a patient who is having a tachypnea of 20 or 28, does it matter? A single value doesn't matter. A trend is mattered. So how do we get that trend? Are we doing something in the wards? This is actually the concept, core concept of emergency, which is also a pre-hospital or a pre-ED management, which we are doing. Can we have this trend? Can we have something, some subsets of some physiological parameters in which we can enter them and find out at what stage they are? So that when they become 20, say 24, we can pick them there rather than 30 or 35.
Pulse and respiration are two very important
things,
especially in labor.
Yes. If it comes to emergency, the sequence always is ABCDE. Airway, we have to look for the breathing, the respiratory rate, saturation, we have to look for pulse rate, heart rate, your CRTs comes into that, and the urine output, your windows, your conscious level. So if we combine all of them together and chart, because we know everything, but we are not on the floors all the time. So who's on the floor? The staff. So if the staff, this is actually meant for the staff, if the staff do and enters those parameters in a periodical fashion, they got a gross chart. And we can able to see that trend, whether they are deteriorating or not. And this is actually cultured in many of the corporates, but still in the government, we are having a lot of tough time to get it established. These are early warning scores.
Another is common complaints of
Gagrat.
We often tend to ignore.
Yes, ma'am. So what subset I was telling, they are basically the early warning scores we get if we do a periodical charting of these physiological subsets. So these are the MIOS what we are doing and how to score exactly, because we have to the color codings of them also. 0 is our normal green. If they are going from 0 to the 1, that is also a significant that trend is going out. Once they were 0 ho jate hain, we are satisfied. But if they are going to the 2 or the 3, if we take a total parameters of 9, that is actually an ICU patient. Only 1 or 2 can be in the ward. The 3, 4, 5 also needs to be in somewhere HD or monitoring area. But yes, more than 5 to 9 has to be in HDU, and ideally 9 to rehna hi nahi hai. And these 9 has to be managed by the critical care consultant, your gynae consultant, your anesthesia consultant. If such a patient goes, everybody has to be on the floor even at night 2 a.m. to save that life. If you leave these patients on the JRs, you are definitely going to lose them. So this is which patient, like what priority, what patient has to be managed by whom is important. And this actually, this is a thesis which Dr. Asmita has done in 2014, but still we are not able to implement it because of the problem with the staff. Our JRs are only doing that. If JRs are doing this also, then they are managing the patients, and it is very, very difficult for that. So this is a government inhibition from the staff area, but this is actually has to be done by the staff on floor, because they know the parameters every day where we have the monitors, and in the ward the patient is deteriorating, they can pick them up at a point number 4 or 5 and accelerate and activate their transfer early to HDUs and ICUs. So this is exactly periphery. Maybe periphery mein aapka patient sick ho raha hai, to aapko secondary or tertiary center karna hai, that is also a referral part. But this is what in hospital which has to be, like this is one of my aim that it has to be in every ward, that they will do the MIO scoring. And this is a little bit customized to the pregnancy, because pregnancy physiology is different from that of the normal adults. So now coming to the why the patient is collapsing, what could be the most common reason of a collapse? Hypovolemia, hemorrhagic shock, but we have other types of shock also. Not all the patients are going in a hypovolemic shock. They can be anaphylaxis, which is very most common, like they can drop at any time because of some hypersensitivity or reaction to the drug. Anaphylaxis, what exactly means, I'll discuss in the later on. But yes, it, you have to be very clear, like drug reaction, a simple rashes is not an anaphylaxis. And if it is actually an anaphylaxis, then what exactly you have to do it. So diagnosing an anaphylaxis and the treatment is also very important. And it is not simple allergic reaction, like patient is having fever or rashes over the body is anaphylaxis. No, it is not an anaphylaxis. Then distributive shocks, we have distribution means they have a peripheral vasodilatation. Anaphylaxis is basically a vasodilatation and patient is having a circulatory collapse. Septic shock is also one of the kind of distributive shock in which everything goes dilated. You give the fluid, fluid will dissipate out, and it, this is not an hypovolumic, but still they are volume responsive. The cardiogenic, you have to restrict the fluid, but they are also shock. They can also have a hypotension and shock. This is a pump failure, MI or valvular. And because our ladies are getting IVFs at 40s, 50s, they have underlying cardiac problems, cardiac pathologies. They can also be presenting with us with the cardiac shock. And the obstructive, most common, if we don't found anything, what we diagnosed in the last is pulmonary embolism. So this is actually an obstructive shock. और इसका भी एक प्रॉपर मैथड है, वी कैन एबल टू डायग्नोज एंड वी कैन सी एक्चुअली एम्बोलिज्म है यानी जो कि हम थियोटिकल पढ़ते हैं, थियोटिकल नहीं होता, वी कैन एबल टू गेट इट इफ वी अप्रोच इन अ राइट फैशन. नाउ कमिंग टू द ट्रिगर्स, येस ऑन द फ्लोर वी डोंट नो, बट एटलीस्ट आर स्टाफ आर पीजीज दे शुड बी नोइंग दैट वॉट आर द फ्यू ट्रिगर्स, लाइक रूल ऑफ 30, लाइक डिफाइंड बाई 30% फॉल इन हेमाटोक्रेट विद 30% फॉल इन हीमोग्लोबिन, फॉल इन 30 millimeters ऑफ सिस्टॉलिक ब्लड प्रेशर. अ ट्रेंड इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. आई माइट बी हैविंग अ ब्लड प्रेशर प्रेजेंटली ऑफ 90, बट इफ इट वॉज फ्रॉम 120 टू 90, दैट वॉज अ सिग्निफिकेंट. इफ इट इज 90, आई एम टॉकिंग इट्स फाइन. एंड द राइज इन द पल्स रेट बाय 30, एंड दिस शॉक इंडेक्स एंड द पेरिफेरी इन द एमरजेंसीज लेबर रूम, द शॉक इंडेक्स एटलीस्ट यू कैन एबल टू गेट. टैकीकार्डिया हो रहा है बट हाइपोटेंशन के करस्पॉन्डिंग इफ यू गो हार्ट रेट बाय SBP, तो दीज हैव टू बी लाइक प्लेस्ड ओवर द लेबर रूम सो दैट वी फाउंड दैट इफ यू आर नॉट इवन डूइंग एन अर्ली वार्निंग, एटलीस्ट वी हैव डूइंग शॉक इंडेक्स और द ट्रिगर्स रेड फ्लैग. तो वाई दिस चार्ट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बींग अ पार्ट ऑफ एन हेमरेजिक शॉक. एंड द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग इज लाइक हाइपोटेंशन इज अ वेरी लेट लेट साइन. तो वी डोंट हैव टू रिलाई कि बीपी कम होगा तभी पेशेंट शॉक में है. बीपी ठीक होने के बाद भी पेशेंट शॉक में हो सकता है बिकॉज शी हैज़ ऑलरेडी लॉस्ट अप टू 1500 ml ऑफ ब्लड. तब तक भी उसका बीपी फॉल नहीं होगा. फिजियोलॉजी में वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ रिजर्व्स ऑलरेडी वॉल्यूम हमारा इंक्रीज हो जाता है. तो द इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज बिफोर बीपीज वी हैव थ्री विंडोज ऑफ सर्कुलेशन इन आर बॉडी. व्हाट आर दीज थ्री विंडोज विच वी कैन टेल द पेशेंट इज गोइंग इन अ शॉक अपार्ट फ्रॉम द बीपी. द फर्स्ट विंडो इज योर ब्रेन. Become anxious, the patient herself can say. The second window is your skin, it become cold, calmy extremity, and the third window is the kidneys. So these are the three windows which can tell you even before the patient is going in class 2 to 3 shock. Class 1 mein hi hame pata chalne lag jata hai, something is wrong from the patient. And if patient is saying something, you have to actually look at the patient. It is not like the patient is getting a psychosis, which is a most common reason. Hypoxia ho raha hai. Patient ne sare cannulas nikal ke phek diye. Patient is going in psychosis. Psychiatric referral kara lo. No, this is a sign of hypoxia actually. And the one important point is, this is the classification of shock which we are doing earlier. But since I am one of the ATLS instructor and in 2020 they have revised American Trauma Life Support. They have revised completely. So they have revised this slide from this slide. And what they have been added, if you can able to very clearly look at that yes, we are getting a base deficit. We don't know how much the patient of trauma lost outside. So I cannot categorize whether it is a class 2 or class 3. So what they have added is a base excess. And it comes from ABG. If you get an ABG of your patient and there is a negative value of BE, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So this minus 6 to minus 10 can correlate with a class 3 shock. I don't know how much has been lost outside. PPH ghar pe bhi ho sakta hai. We never know. But if the patient was fine and getting deteriorated and you find an ABG values of minus 6 to minus 10 or more than minus 10, it is completely acidotic. It is almost class 4 which require your massive transfusion protocol to be initiated in a cases of hemorrhagic shock. Ideally class 4 mein toh aapko karna hi hai. And other triggers are like our parameters. Ek gross bana lo ki hume, but a single value of nothing is actually important. हो सकता है फीवर हो, टेकिकार्डिया इज बिकॉज ऑफ दैट, मे बी बिकॉज ऑफ कंसोलिडेशन और निमोनिया देर इज अ टेकिपनिया. तो इट इज एक्चुअली द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ एवरीथिंग विच इज विच रियली मैटर्स एंड एनी कंसर्न शुड बी एसेलरेटेड रिगार्डलेस ऑफ द स्कोर, राइट. तो वी आर गेटिंग समथिंग क्ल्यू दैट पेशेंट इज गोइंग टू डिटेरेट बिकॉज ऑफ द स्टार सिस्टर्स टोल्ड कि मैम उसका ग्राफ गड़बड़ जा रहा है, पेशेंट इज मोर एंक्शियस. तो द फर्स्ट लिंक ऑफ सर्वाइवल इज अर्ली रिकॉग्निशन एंड प्रिवेंशन. दिस इज एन AHA cycle which is ACLS, BLS ka sabse basic funda. First you recognize and then you act upon. So the first is this is an eye, like you have to recognize early and then you have to take in help and then you give your hands for compression or for resuscitation and then if required a defibrillator, shift to the hospital and then you have to go for a family care. So this is AHA's chain of survival, adult in a hospital cardiac arrest. And wide spectrum of presentations, collapse can be a minor syncopal, which is a self-limiting, most common. Even if it is a self-limiting, at least you address, find the cause. If the patient recovers, it's fine. If not, then you accelerate your level of care a little more. Or to the life-threatening, like sudden onset breathing difficulty, hypoxia, cyanosis, tachycardia, hypotension, and respiratory. If the maternal collapse is not treated, the cardiac arrest can occur. So let's have a scenario based, I'll approach exactly like one patient is in front of us. If the patient collapses, because theory will study, then we will not understand that this patient is female, how we are going to. Anita ma'am, can you read this patient's scenario, most common scenario of the labor room?
Yeah, she's a primary
quarter. So Ventus delivery after 8 hours, the duration is labor pains is actually okay as considered to the primary. Yes, BMI, we are encountering these kind of a patients, but prolonged leaking is one of the other risk factors. Can you anticipate something that patient could be going in a smooth phase, delivered also, or could have something later on? May have PPH, yes ma'am. Sepsis, amniotic embolism, which could be, or otherwise usually these are the routine patients we are encountering and they can, after delivery, they can be very well managed and discharged. Yes. So midway during episiotomy repair, she developed chest discomfort, labored breathing and cyanosis. Actually during the table only. Is it a collapse or a cardiac arrest? It could be collapse. And what could be the differentials? So the differentials has to be in the most common causes. Like embolism is a least common cause. Even she can have a PPH. Or rupture, something, sepsis bhi ho sakta hai.
There was
बट स्टिल कंसील्ड हेमरेज भी हो सकता है, विच यू शुड बी ऑलवेज अ फर्स्ट डिफरेंशियल डायग्नोसिस. बट एज अ रूटीन कॉजेस, वॉट कुड बी द कॉजेस ऑफ मटरनल कोलैप्स? वॉट वी आर इनकाउंटरिंग इन आर, वी आर लेबलिंग एज 5H and 5Ts. तो 5Hs आर हाइपोवोल्यूमिया, येस हाइपोक्सिया, हाइपो हाइपरकेलीमियाज और हाइपोथर्मिया. द पेशेंट कुड ऑलरेडी बीन इन सेप्सिस एंड डेवलप एन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट इम्बैलेंस, हाइपो हाइपरकेलीमिया लीडिंग टू कार्डिक अरिथमियाज कुड बी वन ऑफ द डिफरेंशियल्स इन दिस पेशेंट ऑल्सो. एंड हाइपोथर्मिया, बिल्कुल विंटर्स में आप उसके एपिजियोटमी स्टिच कर रहे हो, शी इज एक्सपोज एंड देन शी डेवलप्स दीज काइंड ऑफ अ फीचर्स. द ब्लीडिंग मे बी कंसील्ड एज यू हैव टोल्ड और हाइपोवोल्यूमिक एंड सेप्टिक न्यूरोजेनिक कुछ भी हो सकता है. Reversible other causes of T's are 4H and 4T's thromboembolism, toxicity. Something is giving, we are giving this patient, we are giving something to stitch. That could be one of the reasons. Tension pneumothorax in our case is a little less, unless the patient is actually having a respiratory problem. So tamponades are also less for our pregnant patients. But yes, in pregnancy, amniotic fluid embolism, pulmonary embolism, local anesthetist or magnesium following traumas. और सुसाइड दे कैन कम लाइक वन ऑफ द फीचर्स, लाइक पहले से ऑलरेडी खा पी लिया हो, बट यूजली वी आर नॉट इनकाउंटरिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ अ पेशेंट्स. एंड एक्लेम्सिया, प्री एक्लेम्सिया एंड इंट्राक्रेनियल हेमरेजेस, दे कुड ऑल्सो बी वन ऑफ द पार्ट्स इफ वी डू. तो क्ल्यू इज टाइमिंग ऑफ कोलैप्स इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, अर्ली और लेट, इंट्रापार्टम, इमीडिएटली पोस्टमार्टम और रिमोट पोस्टमार्टम, दे कैन गिव यू क्लिंचेस यूर डायग्नोसिस दैट वॉट कुड बी वन ऑफ द कॉजेज ऑफ योर पेशेंट बींग कोलैप्स. देन एग्जैक्टली दिस इज एन आरसीओजी दैट they are giving from head to toe the various causes we know. And hypoglycemia is one of the thing if the patient is getting altered or discomfort, at least you ruled out hypoglycemia. This is actually an RCOG and follows ki they are following from head to toe, from throat they are anaphylaxis and aortic dissections, rarely cardiac and hypoglycemias, drugs, embolisms and hemorrhages. So now this case, if we approach, we have few differentials, like hemorrhage should be the first. PPH, it could be atonic, traumatic, uterine inversions or retained placenta. Then coming to the anaphylaxis, the drug reaction could be because of some medicines has been given or the local anesthesia. Then obstructive is amniotic fluid, and the cardiac event could be an MI because the patient is having chest pain. Approach to assessment and resuscitation when there is a maternal collapse. That is what we are here to learn about, exactly how to go about it. I don't know anything, what is the diagnosis of the patient, and I am least interested for knowing the diagnosis because in my hands we have ABCD and we have to resuscitate ABCD. That is why we should not look abhi ki what is problem, what is the problem exactly, because airway will give you 5 to 10 minutes, breathing will give you 30 minutes to 1 hour, and circulation will give you another 4 to 6 hours. So you have to work upon looking for the airway causes, breathing causes and circulation. Once you restore them, then you think back exactly what could be the cause and how we have to go about it. If I'll go in managing and diagnosing the here, I'll lose the patient because of aspiration, right? So the thing is, like, we have to approach, and that is how we have been skilled. Whenever the patient comes, approach in a fashion of an ABCDE. But before that, urgent call for help is actually required. And activation of a response team, fellow residents, consultants on floor, nursing staff, check whether the patient is responsive or not, is should be your first step. Because if the patient is responsive, I'll go for an ABCDE. But if the patient is not responsive, I'll go for a BLS. तो कैरोटिड आपको कब देखनी है, रिस्पॉन्सिव और अनरिस्पॉन्सिव पे डिपेंड करता है. तो सबसे पहले आप पेशेंट को शोल्डर से शेक करके, हो सकता है ट्रांजिएंट हाइपोग्लाइसीमिया की वैसे वो पेशेंट थोड़ा सा डिजी हो गया हो, तो आपको शेक करके एक्चुअली यू हैव टू कॉल, हे हाउ आर यू, एंड सी वेदर द पेशेंट इज रिस्पॉन्सिव और नॉट. इफ द पेशेंट इज रिस्पॉन्सिव, दिस इज एन ACCC अप्रोच. येस, प्राइमरी असेसमेंट फॉलोड बाय सेकेंडरी. आई विल गो इन अ पैटर्न ऑफ एन ABCDE एंड रीसेसिटेटिंग अलॉन्ग विद दैट. See whether the patient is stable or not. If the patient becomes stable, then I'll go for a secondary assessment looking for the fluid indexes. Then I'll take a very specific history, head to toe examination, which is a very focused examination. Few investigation, the point of care. In an emergency, we are talking about point of care, not your LFTs and long list of investigations which needs a lot of time. I want their result within 5 to 10 minutes. That is a point of care. So those tests I want which give me the help in managing my patient right now on the floor. And then you make a final judgment and take a help wherever you need your patient to be shifted or not. So let's go one by one. Along with that, these ABCDE are usually not the physiology which is matching to the adults, it is physiology which is matching to the pregnancy. Because I know if a creatinine value is 1.1, it is bad for the pregnant patient, which is a normal one. A pH of 7.4 8 is normal for pregnancy. They are already in a respiratory alkalosis. A bicarbonate of 18 is accepted in pregnancy. It is a metabolic acidosis in adults. So these values are differing. Since we are focusing only on pregnancy, we should know our physiology very well so that we can see now when our patient is sinking or becoming normal. Because I have seen 18 biocarb per bhi anesthesia people are coming and giving up soda bicarb therapy to those patients. So should not be given like. Okay, if the patient is unresponsive, then the BLS algorithm, I'll go this whole algorithm also at least show so that everybody should know exactly how to do it. So this is a basic like unresponsive, we will go for a BLS. If the patient is responsive, I'll go for a ABCDE approach, right? Now coming to the ABCD approach exactly, if the patient is responsive, the patient is collapsed but responsive. ABCD means airway. What we have to see in an airway? Whether the airway is patent, clear, threatened, that all we have to look about because the patient might not have a patent airway because of secretions which I need to get it clear. So there are few steps of airway I'll tell you. Then breathing may, specifically I want a respiratory rate which is hardly seen on any of the files of ops and gynae department even if the patient is admitted in ICU. Nobody looks at RR. Koi dekhta hi nahi hai. Aapka seedha pulse, BP, conscious. स्टार्टिंग में वही होता है पेशेंट कॉन्शियस ओरिएंटेड पल्स रेट दिस ब्लड प्रेशर दिस सैचुरेशन आ जाता है बट मैम सीरियसली रेस्पिरेटरी रेट नन ऑफ द रेजिडेंट्स आर लुकिंग इन बिकॉज दे आर नॉट इवन लुकिंग एट द पेशेंट वो देखते ही नहीं रेस्पिरेटरी रेट कितना है उसको देखते ही पता चल जाता है काफ़ी चीज़ें एंड दिस इज अ डॉक्यूमेंट्री एविडेंस इन केस द पेशेंट कलैप्स एंड टू स्टार्ट विद द पेशेंट इज हैविंग अ रेस्पिरेटरी रेट ऑफ 30 और द पेशेंट इज हैविंग अ रेस्पिरेटरी रेट ऑफ 14 वेयर द एक्चुअली इवेंट हैज गॉन रॉन्ग वी कैन एबल टू गेट इट इफ वी हैव अ रेस्पिरेटरी रेट डॉक्यूमेंटेड इन द फाइल वर्क ऑफ ब्रीदिंग कोविड में हमने लिखवाना शुरू किया था बट वर्क ऑफ ब्रीदिंग इज ऑल्सो वन थिंग विच कैन टेल यू एग्जैक्टली द पेशेंट इज इन रेस्पिरेटरी डिस्ट्रेस देन ऑस्कल्टेशन ऑस्कल्टेशन फिर भी कर लेते हैं बट नहीं करते हैं पूरा राउंड हो जाता है स्टेथ ही नहीं होता फीटल हार्ट के लिए डॉपलर हाथ में हो जाता है तो एक्चुअली नहीं होता है यूजुअली क्योंकि उसके लिए स्टेथ तो होता है स्टेथ ही नहीं होता तो ऑस्कल्टेशन कहाँ से होगा तो योर सर्कुलेशन से भी पहले योर ब्रीदिंग योर रेस्पिरेटरी रेट एंड ऑस्कल्टेशन आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड यू हैव टू हैव योर स्टेथोस्कोप You can got lot many things. आपका patient edema में जा रहा है पता ही नहीं चलेगा frank edema में जब collapse हो जाएगा तब पता चलेगा आप stress रख कर तो देख लीजिए हो सकता है patient को simple pneumonia के साथ present कर रहा हो patient है ना कुछ भी हो सकता है heart rate rhythm BP and map BP भी हटा दो only this much you go for the chest leads that's very important to monitor these patients then the dysfunction of CNS AVPU dextrose and drugs glascoma scale is very difficult for us to remember but yes alert responsive to verbal commands painful or unresponsive AVPU is one of the chart like we can able to get it and the exposure is head to toe inspection at a glance it can give you a lot of clues give you like patient rash ho raha hai abdominal distension hai actual pore kar raha hai patient ya respiratory rate bahut zyada badha hua hai and if you put a hand on the calf it is tender Hohmann's is positive. At least just have a gross look at the patient. Exposure mein. So it will give you a lot of... Your patient cold kaam extremity hypothermia mein hi ja raha hai. So this exposure of your patient after your ABCDE is a ABCDE ka compact which can give you a lot of clues like where your patient is deteriorating. Now coming to the airway because airway is like one thing which is we are hardly knows how to manage that airway. So can anybody define what is an airway? Ma'am. तो इट इज़ अ पाइप बेसिकली पैसेज पैसेज तो हाउ कैन यू नो दैट माई एयरवे इज पेटेंट राइट नाउ माई एयरवे इज पेटेंट राइट नाउ आई एम स्टैंडिंग आई कैन नॉट हैव अ माई टंग फॉल बिकॉज आई एम एबल टू स्पीक टंग फॉल यू कैन लुक वेन यू ओपन माई एयरवे बट आई एम स्पीकिंग दैट मीन्स द एयरवे इज गोइंग एंड कमिंग माई एयरवे इज पेटेंट One thing very clear. How to identify a compromised airway if I am not talking then? If that airway, if the patient is talking, 10 seconds airway is clear. There is no doubt about it. Either I'll have a gurgly sounds, right? If I am not speaking then, how to identify a compromised airway? Strider is one thing. Respiratory rate could be more because of the pneumonia, could be because of other infection. फर्स्ट कॉम्प्रोमाइज लाइक पेशेंट इज साइनोसिस इज अ वेरी 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 लेट साइन टू हैव एन एयरवे कॉम्प्रोमाइज इट इज मेनली बिकॉज ऑफ ऑक्सीजनेशन प्रॉब्लम्स नॉइजी ब्रीदिंग यस मैम इफ समथिंग इज इन साइड द एयरवे मोस्ट कॉमन इज अ सिक्रीशन इट विल गिव यू अ गर्गली साउंड और अ नॉइजी साउंड और टंग फॉल इट विल ऑल्सो गिव अ स्नोरिंग साउंड द पेशेंट इज अनकॉन्शियस दैट इट सेल्फ मेक अ एयरवे कॉम्प्रोमाइज बिकॉज आइडियली वी टेक अ जी सी एस ऑफ 8 बट यस अलर्ट वर्बल भी नहीं है पेशेंट वीप वीप वीपर आ गया है तो दैट मेक्स द पेशेंट कॉम्प्रोमाइज एयरवे कैन वी गेट अ कॉम्प्रोमाइज एयरवे इन आर सेटिंग्स यूजुअली अ पेशेंट हु इज नॉट टॉकिंग हमारे सेटअप में हमें कहाँ मिलेगा एयरवे यूजली एयरवे एनेस्थेसिया डील करते हैं बट हमारे सेटअप में भी वी आर गेटिंग अ कॉम्प्रोमाइज एयरवे मैम वो तो कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज हो गए अभी हम बात करें कि एयरवे कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड हमारे क्लिनिकल सिनेरियोज में कब पेशेंट को होता है यूजुअली सीजर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लाइक आर पेशेंट दे सीज इवन बिकॉज ऑफ एक्लेम्सिया बिकॉज ऑफ एपिलेप्सी ऑल्सो द पेशेंट इज सीजिंग द पेशेंट इज लूजिंग द कंट्रोल एंड द पेशेंट हैज़ अ कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड एयरवे कैन एस्पिरेट एट एनी ऑफ द टाइम सेकेंड इज दे आर गिविंग अ पोस्ट सेडेशन यस आर पेशेंट्स आर पोस्ट ऑपरेटिव प्रेस लाइक प्रेस इज बिकॉज ऑफ अनकॉन्शियस स्टेटस है ना तो प्रेस मीन्स एनी जी सी एस ऑफ लेस देन 8 इज अ कॉम्प्रोमाइज एयरवे बट येस पोस्ट सेडेशन वी आर गिविंग अ लॉट ऑफ सेडेशन वी आर गिविंग मॉर्फिन टू द पेशेंट्स दे आर कॉम्प्रोमाइज एयरवे इन आर सेटिंग्स एनी वन एनी अदर थिंग इन विच द एयरवे इज कॉम्प्रोमाइज नॉट एबल टू स्पीक चेंज इन वॉइस गर्गली साउंड्स नॉइजी ब्रीदिंग स्ट्राइडर्स ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ ब्लॉकेज इन द एयरवे मे बी ड्यू टू सिक्रीशंस फॉलिंग और फॉरन बॉडी और एडिमा एयरवे एडिमा इज वन ऑफ द साइंस ऑफ could be one of the signs of anaphylaxis that's also one of the part active seizure post ictal very good altered sensorium post op sedations or the patient is going in cardiac arrest because of arrhythmias or anything the patient is having a compromised airway to keep a high index of suspicious for a threatened or a compromised airway in such cases as there can be a rapid deterioration which is necessitating that cpr so you have to have a anticipation usually 95% we don't have a compromised airways हमारे पेशेंट्स में सर्कुलेशन में प्रॉब्लम्स होती हैं ज़्यादा और ब्रीदिंग में हो सकती हैं बट स्टिल देयर आर फ्यू केसेस इन विच वी कैन हैव अ कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड एयरवे एंड इफ इट इज़ देयर वी हैव टू बी वेरी श्योर एग्जैक्टली हाउ टू डील अबाउट दैट हाउ टू एक इज फर्स्ट मैम एक इज विद इन 10 minutes इफ़ यू हैव अ सिक्रीशंस एस्पिरेशन द पेशेंट विल बी मैक्सिमम 10 minutes इट विल ब्लॉक नो एयर ऑक्सीजनेशन इज गोइंग इनसाइड व्हाटएवर इज देयर यू विल रिमेन देयर फॉर 10 minutes टोटल ब्रीदिंग स्टॉप You cannot have a ventilation then. So this track is required for the ventilation. So airway always kills it will not going to take more than 10 minutes if it is completely blocked. So that is why you have to act upon looking for an airway compromise and treat it. Post-op sedations may, I have seen patients post-op mein, post-operative ward mein lita diya, patient deep sedation mein chale gaye hain, tongue fall kar gayi hai, ward mein pade hue hain. Sisters, dekha hi nahi hai, jab tak dekha tab tak wo hypoxia state, patient bilkul ऑल्टर्ड चला गया है वो कोई रिस्पॉन्स कर ही नहीं पाएगा डीप सेडेशन है एंड दैट इज़ हाउ दे किल्ड एंड देन वी थॉट कि वो पोस्ट सेक्शन था हेमरेज था ये था वो था और डायग्नोसिस बताते हैं सडन ऑनसेट था शायद हो सकता है एम्बोलिज्म ही हो गया होगा एक सिंपल एयरवे कैन ऑल्सो किल द पेशेंट इन द पोस्ट ऑपरेटिव वार्ड तो एग्जैक्टली वॉट आर द मैन्यूवर्स टू कंट्रोल दैट एयरवे एंड मैनेज दैट्स ऑल्सो द पार्ट और हमारे पेशेंट सीजर के बाद मेन मेजॉरिटी एयरवे की वजह से ही एस्पिरेट करते हैं बिकॉज वी आर नॉट टेकिंग केयर ऑफ द एयरवे तो एयरवे द स्टेप्स आर देर आर 4-5 स्टेप्स गोज सीक्वेंस वाइज यू कैन नॉट स्किप वन बाय गोइंग टू द अनदर फर्स्ट इज यू हैव टू ओपन एन एयरवे You have to look and then you have to clear it. And then we do a clearing and suctioning. This suctioning everybody has to know. Sister को बुलाते रहोगे आपका patient loose होता जाएगा.
सब काम भी आना चाहिए.
तो आपको suctioning basic आना चाहिए. क्या air भी open करो, clear करो. And उसके बाद you have to see if you I leave it if it again
goes the same.
Normal or goes back. If it is again goes back, that means the patient is having not having such a conscious status to maintain your tongue in the position, then you have to maintain it. And we have two adjuncts for that. और उसके बाद भी पेशेंट स्टिल सेडेटेड है, देन वील गो फॉर लुकिंग फॉर द वेंटिलेशन वेदर द पेशेंट इज टेकिंग स्पॉन्टेनियस ब्रेथ और नॉट. एंड इफ पेशेंट इज नॉट, मैम आई विल गिव यू द पीपीटी. एंड इफ द पेशेंट इज नॉट एबल टू टेक अ ब्रीदिंग, देन यू गिव द ब्रीदिंग विद द हेल्प ऑफ एम्बू. तो दिस एम्बू मास्क इज ऑल्सो वन टेक्निक विच एवरीबडी शुड नोज. तो लेट्स गो वन बाय वन इन अ सीक्वेंस. फर्स्ट आई हैव ओपन्ड द माउथ, सेकेंड इज हेड टिल्ट चिन लिफ्ट, सेकेंड इज आई हैव क्लियर्ड. The third step is I want to answer from your side. The third is I want to maintain that airway. And the maintenance? I have OPAs and NPAs. OPA, like this device, which is from the angle of the mouth to the angle of the mandible. बहुत सारे sizes होते हैं, कौन से patient को कौन सा fit पटेगा. And NPAs from the tip of the nose to the tragus or ear lobe. The diameter is approximately like of a little finger. क्योंकि हमारे nose के अंदर जाना है. तो this is how we select them. And let's see exactly how we put. This is an OPA, which I was telling jelly lagaoge, and it has a curve. Either it will go palate and then we rotate. Usually. And this is a flange-like nasopharyngeal airway. इसका एक bevel होता है, straight होता है. इसको डालने का, इसको भी jelly लगाया, but इसको डालने का technique है. ब्रेन में जाएगा आपका. एक्चुअली डायरेक्शन ये होता है, हम सोचते हैं हमारी नोज ऊपर जा रही होती है, बट नोज का डायरेक्शन इज ऑलमोस्ट पैरेलल टू द हार्ट पैलेट. हां जी मैम.
व्हेनेवर वी आर ऑल 100% ऑक्सीजनेशन इज कंसंट्रेटेड, व्हेनेवर वी टेक ब्रेथ इट इज अ हैविंग अ वाल्व. व्हेन वी ब्रीथ इन दिस ऑक्सीजनेशन अलोंग विद द ट्यूबिंग ऑक्सीजनेशन गोस इनसाइड, व्हाट वी आर गेटिंग इज ऑलमोस्ट 90% एफिशिएंसी. एंड व्हेन वी ब्रीथ आउट द CO2 विल नॉट गो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर चैम्बर. व्हाट इज the most common resuscitative requirement for the oxygenation? Any collapsing patients, it is even ventilators are not giving 100%. But this is a rescue device. We can use only for maximum
60%.
Like any collapsing patient, even at saturation of 40% can pick up a mic. तो फ्लोर पर हमें बच्चों को ये बोला हुआ है कि आपको सबसे पहले अभी लगाओ, उसके बाद हमें फोन करो. एटलीस्ट आप ये बेसिक चीजें तो करो.
पर कितना प्रोपर ऑक्सीजन का कार्य करें?
15 लीटर. क्योंकि वो 90% है फाइव ओ. क्योंकि 15 लीटर. आप 10 लीटर्स कर दोगे तो फाइव ओ 80% जाएगा. वो सीधो अगेन बैकअप तो होगा. तो आइडियली 15% है रिक्वायरमेंट. इसमें 6 या 7 लीटर्स करते हैं. So you attach, आपने ओपन कर दिया and then you giving this oxygenation to the brain. In case the patient is still not breathing.
15
non-breathing mask type oxygenation. If the patient is not breathing, I'm talking about I have opened my airway, my patient is taking spontaneous breaths. If the patient is not taking spontaneous breaths, then everybody have to know exactly how. This is your most common. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल योर एम्बू एंड आंसू के अटैच विद एन ऑक्सीजन सोर्स. ऐसे ही करने बैठा है. उसके भी हमारे पास नॉन ब्रीदिंग मास्क भी होता है. इज अ वायर. सम टाइम इट इज नॉट अवेलेबल, राइट? बट ठीक है, 21 लीटर्स का अटैच करो, बट फिर स्टाफ पे अटैच करिए इन केस इट इज नॉट. दिस इज अ वायर दैट मे बी देयर मे नॉट बी देयर. इट इज देयर, इट विल अगेन गिव 90% ऑफ एम्बू. एंड
उसको फिर ऑक्सीजन सिलेंडर में लगा.
यस सर, उसको सिलेंडर में लगा दो या वॉल सॉकेट ऑक्सीजन सप्लाई जो है
compress
and chin lift. आपकी इससे ईज़ होती है. This is
हाँ,
इसे everything is going across. This compression, this is your cheek. You seal it off. And then you can see the resistance. See the clearance, and then you see the resistance. And how to breathe? How to give the breaths?
30
per minute.
What is anesthetic?
30 per minute.
Am I doing right?
Patency of an airway. Now coming to the part of a breathing. Naloxone is a most common cause of patient having no breathing with cardiac activity is opioid poisoning, and the morphine most common cause. In our hospital settings, we are having a sedation because of that. Post-op sedations could they might be having opioids received, but like in Western worlds, the most common cause is drug addicts. They are narcotics using at home. They have used. Become respiratory, hardly they breathe. Opioids mein bilkul pinpoint pupil hoga unka and breathing rate is hardly 4 to 6 per minute. To kabhi unko koi ambulance call aati hai na, to wo to ambulances mein bhi rakhte hai naloxone. Wo jaate hi sabse pehle defibrillator, to jab cardiac arrest hai. But naloxone denge, it will reverse. Patient to live tha, heart to chali raha tha. To 400 mg ka ek IM shot dena hota hai and they'll reverse. So this is a part of AHA BLS algorithm.
Irrespective of any history.
Irrespective, if you see the patient, no breathing, pinpoint pupil, the drug is naloxone. Pinpoint pupil, only two things. With the carotid present, you just give naloxone, even without the history.
If,
yes ma'am. Every like 5 minutes we can repeat, total 2 grams is the dose. 5 doses we can repeat. But yes, but this is a part not required for us, but this is one of the methodology of basic life support. 5 to 10 minutes ma'am. Total 5 doses. If no breathing but pulse is present, we need to ventilate. We commence the respiratory support with EmboBac 100% oxygenation, or because I can continue that only for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, otherwise my hands are blocked. I cannot be able to go for a further resuscitation. So I need to replace it. I don't want to intubate. So what should be done? I can intubate, but none of the gynecologists should intubate. So the option left with us is to maintain we have a supraglottic devices. So hopefully Procere or LMAs or IGLs, they're available. And this is the thing we can do at anywhere, anywhere. And this is supraglottics are basically meant, designed for the paramedics who are working in pre-hospital ambulance cares. Because whatever the road traffic accidents we are getting, only the EMTs, emergency medical technicians, and what they have been drilled to them. Like whenever you see a patient who is unresponsive, not talking, you feel that patient requiring a ventilatory support. You first clear the airway, put an LMA, put a cannula, start the fluid, take a cervical collar and a spine board. Bas ye panch cheeze karni hai, aap hospital mein mariz le aao. Spine board. Spine board hota hai ma'am, kyunki trauma ke patient ko spine injuries ho sakta hai. We don't want to move them, haath mein utha ke leke nahi aana. They have been drilled. Spine board, cervical collar, because spine protection is one of the step. Airway protection, spine protection and cannula and the fluid. Bas wo panch cheez karte hai. And this is how, in the western world, aap dekho ki humare jo ATLS ke सिनारियो स्टार्ट होते हैं उसमें EMT ने इतने पांच काम किए ही होते हैं. तो वो EMT के लिए डिज़ाइन हुआ था मैम. क्लियर द एयरवे, पुट अ सुप्राग्लॉटिक डिवाइस, पुट अ कैनला, स्टार्ट द फ्लूइड, पुट अ सर्वाइकल कॉलर फॉर स्पाइन प्रोटेक्शन एंड पुट अ स्पाइन बोर्ड इन एन एम्बुलेंस, शिफ्ट द पेशेंट टू द हॉस्पिटल. लाइक हैज़ टू बी इन एवरी सेट, एवरी एम्बुलेंसेज, एवरी इमरजेंसीज, वी हैव टू बी इक्विप्ड विद सुप्राग्लॉटिक्स. हार्डली 3-4 thousand का आता है. And we have various types, जिसमें कि एक में एयर फुल आना होता है, एक में आई जेल होता है, बट इंट्यूबेटिंग LMAs भी होते हैं कि LMA डालकर उससे सीधा इंट्यूबेट हो जाता है. तो देर आर वेरियस टेक्निक्स आर अवेलेबल, बट एटलीस्ट एवरीबडी शुड नो, बी वेरी अवेयर ऑफ व्हाट इज सुप्राग्लॉटिक्स एंड हाउ वी कैन एबल टू गेट इट. बट जब तक आपका नेसेटिस नहीं आ रहा, आपका सुप्राग्लॉटिक भी नहीं है, एम्बू इज़ अ गुड ऑप्शन. बट एम्बू का सील नहीं है और उसको बस हर सेकेंड पर दबाए जा रहे हैं, उसका कोई फ़ायदा नहीं है. It will worsen your patient, right? So we'll see whether we can able to put a supraglottic. I'm not very sure it is an airway Mellican or not. नहीं डाल सकता. Okay. तो I can show you exactly डालते कैसे हैं. It is hardly 30 seconds job. तो this is an ambu.
To make the bag mask assembly, this is the self resuscitator or the ambu bag, and this is the face mask. They are attached like this. And the assembly is complete. To mask ventilate a patient, the mask is kept on the patient's face such that the apex of the mask sits on the bridge of the nose and the base of the mask sits between the area of the lower lip and the chin, or commonly known as the submentum area. The seal is made with the other hand using the index finger and the thumb in the shape of the alphabet C. The C compresses the mask from above, and the remaining three fingers, which resemble the alphabet E, are then aligned over the bony part of the mandible, and the maneuver of gentle head tilt and chin lift is completed, and the patient is ventilated such that 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004, 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004.
एम्बू का भी उन्होंने एक डिस्क्रिप्शन दिया है, दैट दिस इज हैविंग अ कैपेसिटी. आई थिंक साउंड का कुछ प्रॉब्लम है, बट आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू. ओके, यस मैम. हाँ, तो दिस इज एन एम्बू विच वी हैव टू कनेक्ट इट एग्जैक्टली. वी हैव टू पुट ऑन द नेजल ब्रिज एंड द सेकेंड पार्ट ओवर द चिन. वी हैव टू मेक अ टाइट सील यूजिंग अ सी एंड ई टेक्निक. दिस इज हाउ इट इज अप्लाइड. देर इज अ सी, दिस इज अ सी, and these three fingers are a E. Yes. With C and E technique, we are going to compress it by positioning head tilt and chin lift. Maintain your head tilt and chin lift to open an airway, and then you maintain this C and E technique. Now you can see, like, they are opening the airway, because many times it is just placed and pressed, so you are not able to deliver the breath. For that you have to open an airway and then press. One breath every 1 second, and each breath after every 6 seconds. And this is a supraglottic device, an IHL.
This is a supraglottic airway device, or to be specific, this is a second generation supraglottic airway device, commonly called as IHL. It is a preformed supraglottic airway device. It is second generation because it has two openings, one for the airway and one for the gastric emptying or gastric drainage. This is a part of the definite airway in ACLS, it is used as a conduit. Before insertion, the size selection is done based on the parameters which are also written on the specific device. In this case, this is size 3, which could be inserted between the patients who weigh between 30 to 60 kilograms of weight. Before insertion, the device is adequately lubricated. The patient is positioned with head tilt chin lift, the heel of the hand resting on the forehead, and using fingers and thumb, the oral cavity is opened up. The device is inserted such that it has to run close and along the hard palate and not along the base of the oral cavity. During insertion, it has to go smoothly in one go. After insertion, on the universal adapter, 15 mm adapter, breathing circuit or EmboBag can be attached, and the patient will be ventilated as 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004. The contraindications of a supraglottic airway device are severe abdominal distension, inadequate nil per oral time, or any heavy secretions in the oral cavity. Specific, this is a second generation supraglottic airway device, commonly called as iGel. It is a preformed supraglottic airway device. It is second generation because it has two openings, one for the airway and one for the gastric emptying. or gastric drainage. This is the definite, a part of the definite airway in ACLS. It is used as a conduit. Before insertion, the size selection is done based on the parameters which are also written on the specific device. In this case, this is size 3, which could be inserted between the patients who weigh between 30 to 60 kilograms of weight. Before insertion, the device is adequately lubricated. The patient is positioned with head tilt chin lift, the heel of the hand resting on the forehead, and using fingers and thumb, the oral cavity is opened up. The device is inserted such that it has to run close and along the hard palate and not along the base of the oral cavity. During insertion, it has to go smoothly in one go. After insertion, on the universal adapter, 15 mm adapter, breathing circuit or EmboBag can be attached, and the patient will be ventilated as 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004. The contraindications of a supraglottic airway device are severe abdominal distension, inadequate nil per oral time, or any heavy secretions in the oral cavity.
Patient was cyanosis with tachypnea of 38, saturation is 51% in room air, and auscultation may the air entry reduced with conducting sounds. So the what patient what we are having in just my episiotomy. So these are the findings of breathing, and yes, what we have to do, we have to start with 15 liters NRPM and an ABG. तो ब्रीदिंग में आपका रिसेसिटेशन में एनआरबीएम और एबीजी ये दो चीज़ें बी में आनी चाहिए, बिकॉज एबीजी के विल वैल्यू विल कम इन अनदर 3 to 4 minutes. इट इज़ गोइंग टू टेल यू अ लॉट अबाउट योर पेशेंट व्हाट कुड बी द प्रॉब्लम. सर्कुलेशन, हाउ टू असेस द सर्कुलेशन. आई थिंक एयरवे एंड ब्रीदिंग इज ओके, और वील रिवाइज इन द एंड, बट दीज आर द सीक्वेंसेज वील गो अबाउट. तो हाउ टू असेस द सर्कुलेशन इन अ कलाप्स पेशेंट्स एंड हाउ टू रिसेसिटेट अ हेमरेजिक पेशेंट. एवरीबडी, ऑल द गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट आर वेल वर्स्ड. Except few things which is extra I have written here. Yes, heart rate, rhythm, for which we have to see the monitors, ECGs, peripheral pulses for the volume, anxiety, confusion, it indicates hypoxia, CRT which has gone long way, it is now again back in an ATLS guidelines, it is a capillary refill time, should be less than 3 seconds. On the toes of the fingers we can able to see. Then we see the cooled kami extremities, visible bleeding and the blood on the floor. The blood pressure is a very very late sign and the urine output catheterized to check for the urine out. So B कर लिया हमने, फिर हम C के सारे sequences on patient we are going to get it done. And a rule of thumb is, if my radial is palpable, at least I have a blood pressure of 90. If the radial is not, but the brachial at least 80. If the radial brachial दोनों ही नहीं मिल रहे हैं, I mainly go for a femoral at least 70. और femoral भी नहीं है और carotid है तो patient is only 60. आपका बीपी मशीन तक जाने की जरूरत ही नहीं है. इन अ कलैप्सिंग पेशेंट्स जस्ट गो अबाउट इट. इफ़ योर रेडियस आर पैल्पेबल इट इज 90. इफ़ योर रेडियस एब्सेंट बट द ब्रेकियस आर पैल्पेबल एटलीस्ट 80. इफ़ योर रेडियल ब्रेकियल बोथ आर एब्सेंट यू गो फॉर अ फेमोरल, फेमोरल टैप हो रही होती है कभी कभी 70 एंड इफ ओनली कैरोटिड इट इज 60. नो पॉइंट इन पुटिंग अ बीपी कफ लगा के आई नहीं रहा आई नहीं रहा आई नहीं रहा नहीं होता. एटलीस्ट आप बता दो कितना है, एटलीस्ट गिव यू द वैल्यूज. एग्जैक्टली यू गो फॉर इट. एस्टैब्लिश एडिक्वेट वीनस एक्सेस, ब्लड सैम्पलिंग, क्रॉस मैच कोएगुलेशन स्क्रीन आप भेजोगे, बोलसेस दोगे. दीज आर फ्रीक्वेंट बोलसेस. फ्लूइड देना है नहीं देना इज अ होल कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ क्रिटिकल केयर. बट येस फ्लूइड इज 10 to 20 ml ऑफ क्रिस्टलॉइड्स. LUD इन ऑल आर प्रेग्नेंट पेशेंट्स जहाँ पे रिसेसिटेशन हो रहा है 30% ऑफ द वॉल्यूम इज एक्चुअली कंप्रेसिंग बिकॉज ऑफ द IVC. तो वीनल केवल प्रेशर हैज टू बी रिलीव्ड मोर देन 20 weeks. And for that, you just ask the relatives to do an LUD for you. Stop the bleeding, may need to go to the theater. Repeat the fluid challenges. These challenges in a hemorrhagic patient, yes, we can go about 10 to 20 ml per kg. Stat bolus, that bolus means it is not in 4 hours. It has to be less than 1 hour. You have to give that bolus and see for the resuscitation. Why? Because what happened whenever we are giving a bolus of a fluid, only after 20 minutes, 30% state, 2/3 goes off. And that depend upon the fluid what we are giving. If I am giving 5% dextrose, nothing remains in the circulation. So 5% dextrose is totally out of the window for the resuscitative fluid. Only RL or NS depending upon. NS ka you have few drawbacks that we cannot give more than 1 liter because it is itself a hypochloremic agent which can cause hyperchloremic metabolic acidosis leading to the renal AKIs in long run. So we can give 1 liter, but ideally if the fluid is required a lot, then we go for an RL. But if the blood is required, like ATLS says, 1 liter of NS followed by blood. Unko pata trauma hai, O negative blood release karo, chadao, fluid nahi doge aap. To aapka patient bleed kar raha hai, aap O negative first or second release kara do. But RL ke saath blood dena is a problematic because iron has a RL has a calcium, usme anticoagulation hai, they both can combine together. So when you are very clear like your patient require a blood, you go within 1 liter of NS followed by a blood in the ratio of 1:1:1. But if you want to just give fluid for the septic patients, then you go for an RL, and RL ka lactate is not going to increase the lactate of a sepsis because that is going to be metabolized in the liver. If the liver is normal, no renal liver problems, go with an RL. But yes, if there is a renal problem, then go with an NS because that lactate of RL has to be metabolized by your livers. It has a hepatic metabolism. But it does not have to go about it. ABG ka jo lactate bada hua hai, to aap RL nahi doge. This is total misnomer. Okay. So now you have to stop the bleeding and repeat the fluid challenges and transfuse blood and blood products as soon as possible. MTP in a massive class 4 of shock. And this massive transfusion protocol ka jo 4-4 unit hai na, I have seen 24 ghante tak rakha rehta hai, jata hi nahi. So the base angle is also 4 hours. It is not 4-4-4, but it has to be given in 4 hours. That is also very important. Along with the calcium. Along with the calcium, wo 4 release ho jata hai. Because ma'am, maine dekha, wo 4 release to ho gaya tha. Aapke 24 ghante mein bhi nahi ja raha. The patient is going to go in an irreversible thrombo DICs. So it has to be also given back in 4 hours. That 4 hours is also mandate, which is important. Now the finding is, my patient is having tachypnea, tachycardia, peripheral pulses are weak, CRT is 5 seconds, BP is 80. I want the answers from your side. I'm giving the findings of my patient too. The Foley's is inserted, 100 cc of urine come, monitor ECG mein sinus tachycardia hai, and no active bleeding. What could be the cause and what should we do about it? हमने NRPM तो अटैच कर दिया था ब्रीदिंग का, सर्कुलेशन में हमें ये सब मिला, तो हमने एटलीस्ट एक बोलस तो दिया 200. वी नेवर नो, पेशेंट जस्ट गॉट डिलीवर्ड. बट व्हाट कुड बी द कॉज, लाइक वेयर वी आर अप्रोचिंग टू आर डिफरेंशियल्स, देन वी गो फॉर अ DNAE, डीज GCS, AVPU, माई पेशेंट इज रिस्पॉन्डिंग, हाइपोग्लाइसीमिया टू बी रूल्ड आउट, एंड ड्रग्स लाइक मैग्नीशियम एंड एनेस्थेसिया ड्रग्स, ओपिओइड्स जो बोल रहे थे कि मोस्ट कॉमन रीजन ऑफ हैविंग ब्रीदिंग प्रॉब्लम्स, एंड द क्विक सर्वे फ्रॉम हेड टू टो. Any distension of abdomen, swelling of legs for DVTs, uterus stone and contour. So this is a layout I'm giving how exactly what all you have to look about in a sequences of ABCDE. So my patient was very anxious, restless, no visible active bleeding, uterus contracted, contour was maintained, abdomen soft and there is no calf tenderness. Okay. Possibly, or it could be a simple amniotic fluid embolism. But we need to have a trend of few point of care investigations to rule out other causes too. So during episiotomy repair, the patient developed chest discomfort, airway is patent, breathing is cyanosis, tachypnea, hypoxia, hypotension is itself is caused like it could be one of the obstructive shock. इतना quick fast is not a septic one. और hemorrhagic हमने we have ruled out almost. We have started NRBM. Circulation में we are having a circulatory collapse for which we have started a large bore cannula and the fluid has been given. The patient is very anxious and no evidence of external or internal hemorrhage. What to do after ABCTE? अब क्या करेंगे? We have approached. We just have a quick reassessment and look for FGHI. Organize our thoughts. Continue monitoring ABC. Review the effect of resuscitative measures. Decide now the patient needs ICU or theater for stabilization before you move to the secondary assessment. Ab at least aap sochna shuru karo kahan jana hai. Only after the patient is stabilized, move to the secondary assessment. Focus history, focus examination. Yadi still there is a deterioration, you have to reassess ABCD. हो सकता है आपने जो एयरवे या ब्रीदिंग का किया हो दैट माइट हैव गॉट डिसप्लेस्ड. तो अगेन यू थॉट अगेन द फ्रीक्वेंट एंड रिपीटेड री क्लिनिकल रीअसेसमेंट्स दैट प्रोवाइड मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन दैन मेनी अदर इन्वेस्टिगेशंस. तो दिस इज अ फोकस हिस्ट्री. आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू बी डिटेल्ड लाइक दिस इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इमरजेंसी दैट ओनली दिस सैम्पल इज रिक्वायर्ड एंड इट हैज़ अ लॉट ऑफ एविडेंसेज लाइक वाई ओनली दिस सैम्पल नॉट अ वेरी मच डिटेल हिस्ट्री. आई जस्ट हैव हार्डली 1 or 2 minutes. So this history I can deliver, get it from the relatives within 1 minute. Sign and symptoms, what the patient is presented with. Does really the patient has allergy? हमने हो सकता है वावरन दिया उसको और उसके रिश्तेदार बता देंगे कि वावरन से एलर्जी है. Medications received, ये तो हमारा एंटीनेटल था but some patients are high risk having a medications. Obesity था, MI का treatment चल रहा था. Anticoagulant पर थी which we have stopped for 24 hours. Present and past illness. LMP, last meal time because they need an intubation and airway management and operative and review the sequences of events just prior to the collapse. उससे में collapse से पहले किया क्या था? वो sister Wavrin का injection लगा कर गई थी. कुछ तो हुआ था गड़बड़, कहीं तो कुछ हुआ था something. तो this is in a sample history, a mnemonic of a sample is to be maintained and then we see the investigation जो हमने ABG भेजा था पहले. A trend of investigation is more informative. What we have sent plus what the file is having a records. Patient septic shock mein already thi when delivered. It is not ki patient theek thi because patient ko 24 hours se was leaking. Ho sakta hai chorio mein thi. Already hyperkalemic acidosis mein thi patient. If I see the before trends. I'm just saying overall all the sequence consequences like could be there. So you see a delay investigation should not be hurdled in resuscitation. Non-invasive investigation should be done first step. And this is like today's session is complete approach, but me myself is very much interested to give you the concepts of point of care ultrasound. It can tell you, my mentor is Manjupuri ma'am, and she has started Nachi ke through point of care twice. Is baar bhi unhone last month hame call kiya tha, and this is ideally every gynecologist should be well versed. In fact, abhi 4 days pehle in MAMC Department of Medicine called me for this point of care. And they was many of my faculty from MC are really amazed to know कि ये सब भी होता है जिसे हम diagnose कर लें. हम तो बस लिख कर चले जाते हैं, 2 दिन बाद report की date मिलती है, तब तक patient collapse हो जाता है, आधे time तो diagnosis ही नहीं हो पाती है. And this will give you the diagnosis on spot there and then only within 2 minutes. So this point of care, ma'am, not IVC. POCUS includes 3 or 4 all the systems together. Only IVC single value 1.5 is just no value. So it is like, and everything has to be correlated with the patient clinical findings. You don't skip that. So in totality with that patient, I have 2 or 3 differentials. And let me confirm from that. That is the point of care. It has a few of the cardiac windows also. It has a few lung windows also. Being a gynecologist, for the MAMC, we are doing like myself, कम से कम 50-60 ultrasounds हम OPDs में कर ही जाते हैं. एक टॉपिक्स भी देख लेते हैं सारे, बस एक लेवल 2 को छोड़ के वी आर डूइंग एवरी काइंड ऑफ एन अल्ट्रासाउंड्स. तो इफ़ यू आर डूइंग एन एब्डोमिनल प्रोब, व्हाई कांट वी जस्ट पुट द प्रोब ओवर द आईवीसी, ओवर द लंग्स एंड द लिवर शेडोज, ओवर द कार्डियक शेडोज एंड ओवर द योर पैरास्टर्नल्स. इट विल गिव यू द कंप्लीट क्लू व्हाट शुड बी डन फॉर द पेशेंट. इट विल बी अ कंप्लीट डायग्नोस्टिक एंड अ थेरेप्यूटिक टू. तो देर इज अ रश प्रोटोकॉल. बेसिकली आई हैव टेकन अ सेशंस ऑन द रश, विच इज रश इज रैपिड अल्ट्रासाउंड इन अ पेशेंट ऑफ अ शॉक. आई कैन एबल टू डिफरेंशिएट दिस इज अ कार्डियक वन और अ सेप्टिक वन. Just putting a probe, or it is actually a hypovolumic one, or an obstructive, or an embolism. I can able to see the thrombus with that ultrasound. What are the causes of The three components, the pump is your heart. How well heart is pumping, is there any kind of an obstruction like cardiac tamponade, and what is the contractility? Second component is your pipes. How well your pipes, they are leaky or they are overfilled. Overfilled in the cases of pulmonary edema, your B lines, underfilled with an IVC and the cardiac status, we can able to get it done. And the third is your pipes. Tank. What I was telling is tank is filled or overfilled, and the third are the pipes. Whether your pipes are leaky, like hemorrhagic shock, or they are blocked, as in cases of DVT in embolism. So this is how the three, pump, tank, and pipes. This is normal physiology. The pump is, heart is pumping. The tanks, whether they are underfilled or overfilled, and the pipes are whether they are leaky or they are blocked. Heart is your pump. Tank is your preload. Either it is overfilled, you are having an edema. If it is an underfilled, you are having an IVC collapsed. Pani dena hai ya nahi dena hai? That you have to see from the tank. The pipe, whether it is working or not. Overfilled nahi karoge, pipe nahi kaam kar raha. Aur leaky hai to leaky stop karo. Blocked hai to block ke liye thrombolyze karo. This is how you go about it. The pump, pipes and tanks. So you have to look exactly where is the cause, and then you just treat there, and then only you'll treat the patient. तो वो तभी दिखेगा कन्फर्मेटरी, व्हेन यू हैव एन एविडेंस, आपने आंखों से देख लिया है. नहीं तो यू आर ऑलवेज अंडर डायलेमा कि पेशेंट को हो सकता है थ्रॉम्बस ही पड़ा हो, बट आपने देख लिया कि आर ए आर वी स्ट्रेन है, तो दैट मीन्स इट इज अ थ्रॉम्बस. आई थ्रॉम्बोलाइज देयर एंड देन ओनली. तो दीज आर एबीजीज. एवरीबडी शुड बी वेल अवर्स्ड विद एबीजीज. द पीएच ऑफ लेस देन 7.3, डेफिसिट ऑफ -6, बाइकार्बोनेट ऑफ लेस देन 18. Lactates are 4. Does she having a metabolic acidosis? Maybe. Ma'am, ABG ka class hai pura. It will be going to take more than 1 hour. I can tell you detailed ki exactly hum ye kar rahe hain to kyun kar rahe hain. So and end of the secondary assessment judgment, the treating team should be able to decide the patient is stable or unstable, and the definitive treatment for the trigger started while continuing the resuscitation. Now to my patient, yes, saturation improved, respiratory rate is still better, heart rate 116, BP has increased to 80, but still the patient is in shock. And there is no evidence of external and internal bleeding. So what could be the cause? No known allergies. Oxytocin was received, 5 ml of lignocaine was infiltrated, no past illness, and the patient has taken liquids 8 hours back. And the last was taken 2 hours. And the uterus was well contracted, vaginal hematoma is ruled out, cervical tears, broad ligaments, and there is no calf tenderness. This is what my patient is. I have ruled out many, many, many things, and leaving to either one of the amniotic fluid embolisms. The investigation is, my patient is respiratory alkalosis with hypoxia. Hypoxia and hypotension means there is something. If the hemorrhage is ruled out, there could be an obstructive shock. Embolism nahi mil raha hai, so then you go for an amniotic. HB is also 10, lactates are also 1.1, sugars is 108, sinus tachycardia, and the urine ketones nil. So what are the likely causes of collapse in this patient? Narrow dying, hemorrhage we have ruled out, cardiac we have ruled out by ECG, anaphylaxis unlikely, an obstructive shock, either amniotic or a pulmonary embolism. If the actual patient aa gaya, to hum treat kaise karte hain? The next question is, how we treat amniotic fluid or pulmonary? How we diagnose them? DIC, तो पेशेंट DIC से पहले ही पेशेंट विल डाई ऑफ हाइपोक्सिया. द मेजर कॉम्पिटिंग डायग्नोसिस हार्ट फेलियर, न्यूमोथोरिक्स, निमोनियाज. वन ऑफ द कॉम्बिनेशन एक्यूट ऑनसेट डिस्निया, प्रोरेटिक चेस्ट पेन, कफ, हेमोप्टिसिस, एबीजी, रेस्पिरेटरी अल्कलोसिस, हाइपोक्सिया, हाइपोटेंशन, नॉट रिस्पॉन्डिंग टू द फ्लूइड, नॉट रिस्पॉन्डिंग टू द ब्लड. दैट मेक्स अ क्लू कि समथिंग इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिंग विच इज नॉट रिस्पॉन्डिंग योर हाइपोक्सिया एंड हाइपोटेंशन. Unexplained hypoxia, hypotension. Chest X-ray clear. Chest findings clear. Then we have a few differentials. ABG chest X-ray करने के बाद, next approach is echo. Echo comes from point of care. Otherwise, GP पंत वाले तो महीनों तक date नहीं देने वाले. तो because I am doing point of care since 2019, as we got a machine in our gynae emergency. Although हमारी main emergency में नहीं है, but आप heart के ऊपर रख लो. If your RA RV is dilated, it is embolism. Then CT angiography. That is the only investigation. If your patient is stable enough to go to the CT room, if not, you thrombolyze without even that. Unstable patient, you have to thrombolyze here and then only. But if your patient is stable, then you go for a CT angio. No need of fasting, no need of serum creatinine values because patient is dying. आप एक complicated patient को emergency में without even having a creat and a fasting high risk consent पर कर सकते हो. It is not going to give though. If you see a thrombus inside a CTPA, you thrombolyze. And the thrombolysis, if you have seen a CTPA, it is a altiplase, which is hardly not available in MAMC. Altiplase is a drug for thrombolyzing your pulmonary embolisms and your brain strokes. They are also having a window period of 4.5 hours. All your strokes needs to be thrombolyzed if they are thrombuses.
If you are thrombolyzing and the patient
is just postpartum, are we scared of nuclear injury? We can manage, ma'am. But airway and breathing kills the patient before your circulation. That is what we have to look exactly. And if we have a diagnosis in hand, we have to treat that. Taking a risk, take a consent. But you have to treat that. So unstable patient may... If you are having an unstable patient, patient is almost collapsing, you don't have anything, you don't have any clues to that. Yes, embolism could be one of the differentials. Sab kuch rule out kara liya hai. At least ye dose pata hona chahiye, 80 international unit of unfractionated heparin. Hum altiplase nahi use kar rahe hain floors pe, but we are using 80 international unit of unfractionated heparin, which makes a patient of a 50 kgs approximately 4000 unit stat, followed by 18 international unit per kg per hour ka infusion per hour, which is almost 900 to 1000 ml of unfractionated heparin every hourly in an infusion pump. So this is a stat dose which has to be, if you don't remember or if you don't even have, you give clexane at least 40 ka stat dose abhi subcutaneous BD. But better to give a heparin ka dose unfractionated 4000 stat followed by 1000 ml per hour. The investigations are Doppler's, 2D echo, ventilator perfusion scannings for antenatal patients and a CT pulmonary angio for your postnatals or any of the patients. It will give you a report in 30 to 40 minutes, CT pulmonary angio. Even in the busy settings of emergency, if I go, like I have a complete suspicious, I want CTPA, I can able to get it done in half an hour. So, in corporates, it is a like kind of a protocol, if the patient is coming, stroke, ka, MI, ka, ya, embolism, ka. So they have a window period, वहाँ का door to needle time होता है and then they will give you the dates, time exactly और वो thrombolysis भी हम CT room से ही start हो जाती है. So this is how actually emergency works on toes. They already have a timer started whenever the patient comes and we have a balloon times for that. Amniotic, yes, it is a completely conservative management. As such, only diagnosis is clinical. And it is acute hypotension, respiratory distress, hypoxia followed by coagulopathy is very, very important part. Seizure and cardiac arrest may occur. The pathology process is akin to anaphylaxis to severe sepsis due to complement activation. You need respiratory support, intubate, ventilatory support, maintain BP, coagulation correction. That is all you have to do. You don't have any particular drug to get it corrected. Now the next is a very important part is anaphylaxis. Can anybody tell me what is anaphylaxis? Sudden onset severe reaction in the form of allergy, khujli ho rahi hai, is this an anaphylaxis? Cardiorespiratory collapse along with this, in the sense the patient become hypotensive or the patient collapses, totally become unresponsive. Stages, will you let your patient go in a higher stage? Yes, there is a stage. At last, there is a death wala stage bhi hai. So when you want to pick them early. So what is actually a definition? Yes, it is a serious hypersensitivity reaction. Rapid onset may cause death. It is characterized by potential life-threatening compromise in airway breathing circulation. May occur without skin reactions also. So the base part is that we have 3 points. Acute onset of illness with a sudden progression. Skin may or may not be there, but there is a life-threatening A, B, C. Aapne kuch diya, usse ek hypersensitivity hui, and there is a problem in A, B, C. What? The patient may have hoarse voice or stridor. The patient may have increased work of breathing. If you put a stethoscope, it is complete wheeze. Wheezing means patient is anaphylaxis. सिंपल ए और बी से ही आप पिकअप कर लोगे. स्ट्राइडर एंड अवीज मीन्स पेशेंट इज गोइंग इन एनाफाइलेक्सिस. आप बीपी तक भी नहीं वेट करना है. और लो बीपी साइंस ऑफ शॉक्स, कन्फ्यूजन एंड रिड्यूस कॉन्शियसनेस. येस, कॉल फॉर हेल्प इज अ थिंग, बट इफ यू आर ऑन द फ्लोर एंड द पेशेंट इज गोइंग लाइक दिस, सीधा क्रैश कार्ड से ADR उठाओ 0.5 ml. वन एम्प्यूल इज एक्चुअली हैविंग 1 mg विच इज 1 ml. I'll go for a 0.5 ml deep IM thigh. उसके साथ फिर आप एयरवे और ब्रीदिंग ऑक्सीजनेशन फ्लूइड स्टार्ट करो. बट योर ड्रग इज एड्रेनलिन 0.5 ml IM. कब देना है? एयरवे ब्रीदिंग सर्कुलेशन के सिम्टम्स आना शुरू हो जाते हैं इन अ पेशेंट ऑफ सडन ऑनसेट हाइपरसेंसिटिविटी. स्किन रिएक्शन मे और मे नॉट बी अवेलेबल. इफ ABCD इज नॉर्मल स्किन रिएक्शंस, प्लीज डोंट गिव ADR. इट विल वर्सन योर पेशेंट. So you have to be very specific exactly where you have to give it. And this is a resuscitation council guidelines. सीधा मैम, सीधा बिना डाइल्यूट करे, सीधा 0.5 आधा एम्प्यूल तोड़ के दे दो. सडन ऑनसेट ऑफ एयरवे ब्रीदिंग सर्कुलेशन एंड यूजली स्किन चेंजेस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इशी रेस, यू कॉल फॉर अ हेल्प, कॉल रिसेसिटेशन टीम और एम्बुलेंस. रिमूव द ट्रिगर. इफ इट इज एन एक्टिव ट्रिगर प्लीज रिमूव इट. स्टॉप एनी इन्फ्यूजन्स इफ इट इज गोइंग, दैट इज अ फर्स्ट स्टेप. लाई द पेशेंट फ्लैट विदाउट द लंग्स लेग्स एलिवेटेड, ऊपर नहीं करने मे बी. एंड देन यू हैव टू सिटिंग पोजिशन मे मेक द पेशेंट ब्रीदिंग ईजियर. इफ प्रेगनेंट लाई ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड. गिव IM ADR. After that, you establish airway, give high flow oxygenation, apply monitors, pulse oximeter, ECG, blood pressure, and fluid challenge, which is पीछे लिखा हुआ है. At least you will give 100 ml का fluid there and then only 100 ml. Otherwise, आप total पूरा fluid भी resuscitate कर सकते हो. And observe your patient in another 5 hours, 5 minutes. If still there is no response, you can repeat second dose after 5 minutes.
Same dose,
0.5 ml. उसके बाद भी नहीं होता तो उसके बाद भी इनका पूरा एक एल्गोरिथम है कि उसके बाद आपको इन्फ्यूजन स्टार्ट करने हैं. मे रिक्वायर एन आयरन ड्रॉप्स बट यहाँ तक यूजली 99% रिवर्स हो जाता है. बट इफ़ यू हैव गिवन दे कैन रीअकर आफ्टर 4 hours. इफ यू हैव गिवन एन ADR दैट मीन्स योर पेशेंट हैज़ टू बी इन ICU फॉर अनदर 12 hours. इट हैज़ टू बी इन ICU बिकॉज दिस इज रिकरेंट द सेम एलर्जी विच यू हैव स्टॉप्ड एनाफाइलेक्सिस. इट कैन अगेन रीअकर विद दैट सेम इवेंट विच हैज़ बीन गिवन ट्रिगरिंग इट. द सेम ट्रिगर मे कम अनदर. इट इज़ अ बायोफिजिक रिएक्शन तो इट कैन अकर 4 or 6 hours आफ्टर. एटलीस्ट फॉर 1 day 24 hours योर पेशेंट हैज़ टू बी कम्प्लीट मॉनिटर. देर मे बी द पेशेंट हु इज़ नॉट रिस्पॉन्डेड इवन विद 2 doses. इसके आगे का फिर काफ़ी हाई हो जाएगा. बट येस उसके बाद ADR इन्फ्यूजन्स आर स्टार्टेड तो उनकी डोजेज एंड ऑल होती हैं. बट येस यू हैव टू स्टार्टेड. बच्चों की डोजेस अलग होती है. अभी तो हम एडल्ट्स पे ही हैं तो वी आर जस्ट लिमिटिंग आर सेल्फ. एंड द केस कंटिन्यूड वी प्लान फॉर द वेंटिलेटरी आयनोट्रॉपिक सपोर्ट एंटीकोएगुलेशन. शी थ्रो सीजर्स विथ फ्रॉदिंग फ्रॉम द माउथ. माय सेम पेशेंट. हाउ शुड वी मैनेज? लेफ्ट लैटरल पोजिशन, एयरवे क्लियरिंग, सक्शनिंग, गुडल्स, 100% ऑक्सीजनेशन. पोस्ट सीजर पेशेंट बिकम अनरिस्पॉन्सिव. वॉट शुड बी डू? Unresponsive, call for a help. Activate a code blue team, obstetricians, intensivist or pediatrician and check for the breathing in 5 to 10 seconds. I'll just demonstrate. Uske baad I'll go with the PPT.
Sternum ka lower part of sternum ka upper part. This is where I have to put my hand
It is not the whole palm, it is only the heel of my hand has to be there. Cross my fingers, my elbows and shoulders are straight and movement is through the back. Like this. And it is count of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How much, what should be the quality of compression? I want that range should be at least 100 to 120 tolerance. That is the first thing. How much depth? At least 500 tolerance. Not more than 600. 30 compressions followed by 2
tolerance.
If I am doing this, as she is my second rescuer, provider number 2, she will be delivering.
See?
30 ke baad she will be delivering 2 breaths. Let's just hold up. That press should not be so much. It is going to increase the positive pressure and the pressures of stomach. It is only just the visible chest press. And my hand should be off when she is doing. They can be over the chest, but they should not have this. So that she can able to deliver the press. 30 compressions, 2 breaths. 30 compressions, 2 breaths. Total 5 sets has to be completed in 2 breaths.
Or single ho to chest compression each other.
Single nahi hai, toh bhi you can take a break and you can give. Pocket mask is a better option. But if you don't have a pocket mask at home or you don't have a lambo, only chest compression is also one of the techniques.
Yes.
So, press karte karte hospital le to.
Yes.
So, this is a pre-hospital cardiac expansion.
So,
but
then
again,
30 stop.
I am all around. I can go to the...
My mouth.
Mouth, you have to just pinch the nose. And then again,
it will be okay if only chest compressions are continued.
Yes.
Without any breaks.
Because the patient has enough oxygenation
yes.
in the air.
Yes.
Abhi saturation is ABG to 95. That is 55. Now deliver the curl. And my aim of compressing is I want to deliver with my pressures. I can able to increase the BP so that my blood will be delivered to the brain and the heart. I just want two organs to be damaged. Brain and heart. वो चलते रहेंगे और टॉक्सिक ब्रेन इंजरी भी होगा इसके बाद अभी से इफ मैम गॉट एडी एट एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम दिस एवरीथिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज डीएस एंड एडी इज अ पार्ट ऑफ डीएस इफ आई एम कंप्रेसिंग लेट मी ऑलमोस्ट 3 साइकल्स 30 कंप्रेशंस की 3 सेट्स हो चुके हैं एंड आई एम ऑन द फोर्थ वन आई एम कंप्रेसिंग एंड शी गॉट एन एडी तो एडी को आई Then she, I'll continue with the compression. She put an AED. AED may, there is an on button, you on, and then AED starts commanding. If you put an on button, AED has to be milta. I think it will be yoga.
Let me stop the compression.
Or if BLS converted to ACLS, ACLS ambulance team aapke paas aa jati hai, all drugs ADRs, they are the part of ACLS. ADRs, if you have got axial compressions, defibrillators, AD is only automated in which you are not able to see the rhythm, only it is saying whether it is a shocking.
How to identify and manage a cardiac arrest? What are the modifications to routine resuscitation as compared to the ops patients? And what are the medicines? So we have to look for the breathing, air entry and carotid. If there is no breathing, no carotid, it is a cardiac arrest, right? So the team leader, the most experienced person who knows the protocol, checks for the responsiveness. Then shout for the help. Ask the provider one to bring the crash cart and the defibrillator and activate a code blue team. What I have been doing here. उसके बाद देन यू चेक द कैरोटिड एंड द ब्रीदिंग इन 5 सेकेंड्स बट नॉट मोर देन 10 सेकेंड्स एंड इफ नॉट एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई द पल्स एंड द ब्रीदिंग देन गिव कमांड टू अनदर प्रोवाइडर टू स्टार्ट अ हाई क्वालिटी चेस्ट कंप्रेशन आइडियली टीम लीडर शुड अनाउंस एवरीबडी इफ देर इज नो वन देन टीम लीडर शुड बिकम द प्रोवाइडर टू इट सेल्फ बट प्रोवाइडर वन को उसने दौड़ाया है फॉर क्रैश कार्ड That's required. Otherwise, you'll end up doing compression and you'll again become a victim after half an hour. So you want somebody to be on floor to take your help. Now, the provider 2 starts compression or the team leader can start the compression at the rate of 100 per minute. The compression rate should be 100 per minute, but you have to give 30 compressions to start with. And it is a lower half of sternum, same in the non-pregnant patient. It has to be the same. The provider 3. प्रोवाइडर वन चला गया था टू ने कंप्रेशन शुरू किया टीम लीडर खड़ा हुआ है अनाउंस कर रहा है प्रोवाइडर 3 टेक केयर्स ऑफ एन एयरवे ओपन द एयरवे हेड टिल चिन लिफ्ट डिलीवर 2 प्रेस एंड 30 कंप्रेशंस यूजिंग बैग एंड मास्क एंड द इंटरचेंज रोल बिटवीन 2 एंड 3 आफ्टर एवरी 2 मिनट्स 5 साइकल्स ऑफ 30 कंप्रेशन 2 प्रेस टू रिलीव द प्रोवाइडर्स फटीक इफ यू हैव प्रोवाइडर 4 और इफ यू हैव समबडी लेमैन रिलेटिव्स यू कैन आस्क देम टू पुट एन LUD बस आप इसका यूट्रस डिस्प्लेस कर दो टू वन साइड That's very important. It will many of the times with only this technique, 30% of the circulation can comes from the lower limb, and you relieve of the circulatory collapse. Then the provider one notes the time and activate the code blue team if not done till now. Brings the crash cart, jo lene gaya hua tha, and the defibrillator, and attaches to the pads. Check the cardiac rhythm on the monitor or the defibrillator. Defibrillator mein hame dekhna hota hai, so we have to know what is shockable and what is non-shockable. But yes, ADs only cannot show but tell you it is a shockable or not. If the rhythm is shockable, you have to deliver 200 joule of biphasic there and then only. Same as in non-pregnant and immediately resumes chest compression. So what the two waves I am getting here is, first is a broad complexes which is very much regular. These are VT and the second is totally haphazard. These are VF and VT and VFs are the shockable rhythms. If you are getting a straight line, it is non-shockable, it is asystole. If you are getting a normal activity without a pulse, it is a pulseless electrical activity, it is also non-shockable. So shockable, if I am getting these kind of a complexes, a regular complex is broad or a haphazard complexes. Now the provider 4 puts IV cannula if not inserted, send the samples and check for an APG and give 1 ml of epinephrine. अब हमने ये इन हॉस्पिटल की बात कर रहे हैं तो यस वी आर गोइंग फॉर एन ACLS द नेक्स्ट ड्रग इज ADR पूरा 1 एम्प्यूल अनडाइल्यूटेड जाएगा फॉलोड बाय 20 ml ऑफ अ बोलस बिकॉज यू डोंट हैव एनी एक्टिविटी आपको पुश करना है हार्ट तक वो ADR राइट दीज आर VFs एसिस्टोल्स पल्सलेस इलेक्ट्रिकल एक्टिविटीज एंड VTs VF एंड VTs आर शॉकेबल एंड द एसिस्टोल एंड द पल्सलेस इलेक्ट्रिकल एक्टिविटीज आर नॉन शॉकेबल और प्रोवाइडर 4 ने आपको कैनला डाल के ADR पुश कर दिया है प्रोवाइडर 5 यदि कोई और है तो एक रिकॉर्डर भी होता है जो रिकॉर्ड और टाइम नोट भी करेगा एंड द ऑल प्रोवाइडर शुड फॉलो द कमांड ऑफ टीम लीडर एंड गिव द कंस्ट्रक्टिव फीडबैक दिस इज एक्चुअली एन ACLS ईच साइकिल ऑफ CPR कंप्राइजेज ऑफ 5 सेट्स ऑफ 30 कंप्रेशन 2 प्रेस टेक 2 मिनट्स टू परफॉर्म एंड आफ्टर ईच 2 मिनट्स विद इन 10 सेकेंड्स बिकॉज प्रोवाइडर 2-3 विल बी गेटिंग सो मच टायर्ड तो उनका रोल चेंज होना है Provider 1 will check the rhythm and the provider 2 compressor will check the carotids. So this is all the three things has to be done in 10 seconds at the end of 2 minutes. And that you have to minimize interruption in chest compression for less than 10 seconds. This is a whole cycle of CPR which will be going. and high quality CPR, that means rapid chest compression 100 per minute, hard compression depth of 2 inches, adequate chest recoil, minimize interruption, avoid prolonged pulse check, resume compressions immediately after shock, switch provider compression every 2 minutes to avoid fatigue and LUD. They are the part of high quality chest compression. Everything is going on, patient is not able to get revived. But I have to activate my ops critical care team, emergency team, at the starting of compression. But I'll wait for another 4 minutes. Looking for the reversible causes, 5H and 5Ts. ABG ka sample bheja tha. Dekha uski kya report aayi. Saath mein point of care ultrasound can be one modality by which we can able to see thrombosis. RARV hai epigastric mein dal ke. To aap isko वहीं पर क्लेक्सिन स्टार्ट करा दोगे. तो यू आर लुकिंग फॉर रिवर्सिबल कॉजेस. एपीजी हाइपरकैलेमिया तो नहीं था, रिदम्स में क्या आ रहा है, एसटी एलिवेशन तो नहीं आ रहा है, हाइपरकैलेमिया, अदर इलेक्ट्रोलाइट, मैग्नीशियम ज़्यादा तो नहीं है. तो व्हाटएवर यू आर गेटिंग, यू आर जस्ट ट्रीटिंग एंड कंप्लीटिंग योर 4 मिनट्स. 4 मिनट्स तक भी नहीं हुआ तो ऑल दो इट इज़ ए वेरी मच लीसली ट्राइड एवरीवेयर, बट आफ्टर कंप्लीशन मी माई सेल्फ हैज़ डन 4 पेरीमॉर्टम सिजेरियन सेक्शन. Because you have to activate your team, you have to wait 4 minutes ka resuscitation, 4 cycle ho gayi, nahi ho raha. If you take out the bachcha, baby out, 30% circulation jo tumhara aa raha tha, jo compressed out tha, it will again go to the heart and it will give a click of heart. Because most of our patients are not a circulatory stop, cessation of heart. It is pulseless electricity, that means they don't have enough volume to resuscitate, to generate a carotid. They are actually pumping. If you put an ultrasound, they are actually pumping, but they are not generating enough volume to have your carotid bounce. Their BPs are actually less than 60. And you need to give them fluids. If they are hyperkalemic, yes, you need to treat the metabolic acidosis. But if you give that kick from their IVCs ke niche lower, it will going to reverse the patient. This is the first step, which is an AHA test, like provider continuous LUD dispatch. Perform PMCS if no ROSC, if no reversal of spontaneous circulation in 5 minutes. Perimortem cesarean delivery and neonate team to revive the baby also. Out of my 4, although we saved one mother, but we saved 3 fetuses also. Because the 5 minutes the baby can tolerate hypoxia. The drugs, epinephrine 1 mg IV or IO every 3 to 5 minutes. 3 to 5 minutes means ADR once given it has to be after 2 cycles. 4 minutes ke baad hi dena hai. Log ek hi minute mein 3 baar ADR bhi dilwa dete hain. Useless. Patient will deteriorate. Uski kidneys completely collapse ho jayengi. Uska kabhi AKI reverse hi nahi hoga even if you have revived. So 1 ampule is 1 mg which is 1 in 1000 and diluted form mein doge followed by 20 ml of a normal bolus. VTVF hai. So second drug is amiodarone. 300 mg ka IV bolus. And if there is a magnesium sulfate, then you give calcium. Bicarbonate is usually not recommended. And the fourth drug is normal saline. That means see care, otherwise it will again going to go if you don't give the further management. And that again comes in a form of an ABCDE. You have to go for an airway management. You have to intubate if not done. BP control map of 965. Look for the reversible causes. Yadi nahi diye. Or target temperature current management. Up cold, thoda hypothermia, you will maintain and do for a multimodal neuroprognostication because they might have hypoxic brain injuries suffered. So this is a ROSE care. Yes, intubation, breathing, vasopressors, look for the reversible causes and monitor the core body temperature, oxygenation, glucose, avoid barotrauma, temperature targeted control, oxygenation, glucose, EEG. At least we should know ki ICU mein jaake hame karna kya hai patient ka. So this is post ROSE. And resuscitative hysterectomy, yes. And there is a 5-minute rules. We have few logistics. Many are saying that if you take out the baby without a consent, they are going to sue you. But in case we have a documented evidences in which the patient who has not done an PMCS, they have gone sued outside. We have few cases, case reports also. Jahan they have, because why haven't you taken out the baby? Why have you given the maximum chances of survival to my mother? So there are legal cases reported if you don't do a PMCS. There are many actually reported. It should be performed where the maternal collapse. You should not take the patient to an ICU. There and then only on the floor, on the corridor, on the ward, on the same bed it has to be done. 4 minutes you have to initiate, take out the baby by 5 minutes, not necessarily to confirm the presence of fetal heart. It is for the maternal resuscitation. I am not interested for the baby. It is all for the mother we are taking. Do not delay for the lack of consents. Only the scalpel, you just pour a betadine. Scalpel cut vertically, abdomen in one part, uterus in second, take out the baby, vertical laparotomy hai, and continue the CPR, that anesthesia team will continue. And ROSC, if achieved, you packed and then take to the OT, but if not achieved, then you stitch there and then only. And this is in totality of whatever we have discussed, OPS Cardiac Arrest Resuscitation Council, UK MBARS 2021. Start with a confirmation of cardiac arrest, then lie flat, apply manual uterine displacement, commence CPR, identify team leader, reallocate look. So the important part is the team management. A lone person cannot do all the things. So everybody has to be done and the team leader should be there. Apply defibrillator, pads, check cardiac rhythms, shockable, give shock, non-shockable, non-give. After that ROSC achieved, you maintain an airway and ventilation, maintain circulation. Emergency hysterectomy, if required for your patient, you will get it done. Post-resuscitation from hemorrhage, if the patient is from hemorrhage, you will go for a massive transfusion protocols. And you have to look for 5H and 5Ts. And the fluid IDR, amiodarone, calcium, magnesium, thrombolysis, PCI, tranexamic acid and intralipids. They are the drugs which has to be given. And the last is communication. Everything has to be communicated. If you have done wonders on the floor, but nothing has been communicated to the patients, you are again going to have a lot of legal impacts. Breaking a bad news is itself is a one-day whole session, exactly how to go for a communication skills and breaking a bad news, debriefing, documentations, document whatever you have communicated, communicate whatever you have documented, and how one prepare a maternity unit to be effective to deal with a maternal collapse. The resuscitation equipments should be well aware, everybody should ensure where they are kept. PMCA's cup, one of the delivery sets has to be there in HDUs. Scalpel, blade, everything, sutures has to be there. Everyone who manages a maternal cardiac arrest should know where the emergency equipments are kept, including your PMCS. You should know how to apply, how to initiate a defibrillator. Simulation techniques is required. Run regular drills for managing the collapse is required. So the key points are excellent team dynamics, clear allocation of roles, closed loop communication is the key to success. Resuscitative hysterectomy, yes, it provides ultimate relief of aortic cable compression and is performed to optimize the maternal outcome. Ensure effective communication with family, documentation and debriefing. Debriefing of your team is also required, not only the patients. Anything happened, everybody is like in a state of a shock. What went wrong? What went right to start with? Were we able to enough manage the patient? Even if we lose the patient, we have done very much right steps. Always boost your team first and then go with a what could be better rather than what could be, what wrong you have done. Never ask this question. What could be better? How can we improve upon next time? So these are the few questions of debriefing. In fact, ma'am is also doing that debriefing. Respectful maternal care, they tells you ki debriefing karna kaise hai. Then ensure preparedness of your team. Simulation trainings to ensure emergency preparedness and the regular run drills to manage a maternal cardiac arrest. That's all.